Say you have a water bottle that you want to put in your car that doesn't fit, and things like that can drive you insane. As a maker, you're going to try and fix it. Laser cutting is your solution, not the 3D printer. This took 11 hours to print. This in a car under heat, because it's PLA, will start to sag and get all goopy and weird. This, not so much. Don't get me wrong, I love my 3D printer. It has its place. It does certain things incredibly well. Start looking at whether the laser cutter can do what you need and stop spending so much time on 3D prints. Hold on. You're thinking, I can't afford a laser cutter. If you can afford a 3D printer, you can afford a laser cutter. Stick with me. A lot of people spend too much time looking at stuff and going, can I 3D print it? I've always looked at a few things as far as order of operations. First, I design something up. Second, I try to figure out if I can buy what I need. And if I can't buy it, then what I do is I look at how do I make it. And the first tool I go to is...
That is to have sharks with frickin' laser beams attached to their heads.
Is the laser cutter. The reason why I always go to the laser cutter is because it is incredibly fast. It's the next day. And I realized that I did not give the printer a fair shake, because it's not printing out the same thing as the laser cutter. So let's do that. Turns out it takes about 6 hours, not including assembly time. When we start a project like this, we got to take some measurements. We figure out how big the Nalgene bottle is and how big the cup holder is. And then we start doing a 3D model. In this case, it took me 3 iterations to do this. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, wait a minute. If it took you 3 tries to get this, if I printed this out 11 hours 3 times, it would have been 3 or 4 days until I actually got to a final product. I got to this from the beginning of the morning, and then at noon I had the final product. This would have taken me days. Seems to be a big time discrepancy there. Keep this in mind, that you can do something like this to get a structure, figure out what works, and then go to 3D printing afterwards if this is your thing. Everybody's thinking Glowforge, you're probably looking at a couple $1,000s. And as soon as you look at some of the other lasers out there that are slightly bigger or a little more robust, you're probably looking at like $5,000 to $10,000. The new diode engravers can cut 3mm wood pretty darn fast and cost you like $800 or less. The Algo Laser 22W Alpha that is out right now is $800. Algo Laser did send me this, and yes, I am promoting their product, but I'll be completely honest, for this price point, you get air assist, you have wireless, it just works, and it's quick, it's clean, and it's fast. If you want something like this, you can find an affiliate link down below, because that's how this channel is supported. All the parts here that you see in this are done in 20 minutes. Make sure you take the safety precautions you need to. Have safety squints on. Make sure that you have good ventilation and or a fan to suck the smoke out, because it's gonna make smoke. That's the way it works. Assembly time took me less than 5 minutes. And a little bit of gluing, another 5 minutes. So we're looking at 30, 35 minutes. And I've got a working prototype. I also know that some are going to say that what about the Bamboo Labs or some of those high-speed printers out there? And yes, you are absolutely correct. Some of them out there are amazing. But from what I understand, I don't have one, they print about twice as fast. So 3 hours to 20 minutes. Lasers are still winning here. And the laser will cost you a lot less than a Bamboo Labs printer. Just saying. Start looking at whether the laser cutter can do what you need and stop spending so much time on 3D prints.